What's up, everybody? The Surreal Andre, aka New Era X Saint, with episode 7, Quest for West. And today is a big day because I get a fucking gold duplicate in the first pack. Okay, woosa. Anyway, it's not even a good gold duplicate. I mean, Tom Sanders is alright, but come on. At least I wouldn't have been upset if I got like a duplicate Iverson. Haha. Anyway, today, game 7, NBA Finals. This is what it's all about. I am pretty excited. My last video, I said I wasn't that excited because I wanted the Spurs to win that game 6 and put them away. But I am really excited because I realized this is what basketball is all about. One game, one LeBron, one ball, one shot, no hairline. This is it. This is it. Tonight is, I want to see a game winner tonight. Tonight. I want to see a Jordan moment where he pulls up. Was the one that they always show in the commercial where he fist pumps his ass off right after he makes it. I think that was on the Jazz. Not sure. But that's what I want to see tonight. I want, at least if the Heat's going to win, I at least want to see it happen in a way that keeps me on the edge of my seat, because as soon as I see LeBron hold up the trophy, if he does, my heart will just, you know, it will be a repeat of last year where I just won't hear the end of it from the Heat fans all over the place that have, you know, the Heat fans since 2010. Bleh, you know how those people are. But anyway, tonight, it was like Shaq said after game 6, I couldn't wait for Thursday to get here. It can't get here quick enough. And Andre Kirilenko, great pickup in this gold pack because he's worth quite a bit. I think like 18,000, great price tag on him. And that turned this 30k pack opening into a near 50k, which is what in turn ends up getting me my new gold legend and some bullshit that you'll see later on in this video. But anyway, LeBron, I wouldn't mind, I don't care at this point if LeBron wins again. I don't care if the Heat win another ring. The only reason I'm upset if they do is because then you have to hear it from their fans, and you have to admit, the Heat have the most annoying fans in the league. I have nothing against Heat fans, but you're annoying as shit. You really are. You are. I'm sorry. I have yet, there's only one friend that I have that's a Heat fan, Andre Blatch. Another good pickup. He should be worth more in this mode because he's a great pickup, especially because his mid-range is on like almost a 90. But anyway, yeah, I only have like one friend that's a Heat fan, and he's bearable because he's as big of a Heat fan as he is, he's that big of a LeBron fan. And he wasn't a Heat fan until LeBron went to the Heat. He was mainly a LeBron fan. But Heat fans tend to be extremely annoying. I'm sorry, but it's just true, and if you're not a Heat fan, you know what I mean, because you just know what I mean. So, I don't care if the Heat win their next ring. I care because I have to put up with their fans for the entire offseason, and their fans being more than half my friends. And that's just not fun. Because then every time I have to go out and play basketball at the park, there's always somebody yapping about how LeBron and the Heat took a two-peat and they're going for their third. But that is just if, at this point. Because I personally think the Spurs are going to win. The Spurs, they know better. They're not going to. I think Tim Duncan is going to have like 30 points, 12 rebounds, 2 blocks, and 3 assists. If I get that stat line correct, I deserve a ring myself. But Tim Duncan will have that. Tony Parker will have a great game. The only way the Heat will win tonight is if everything clicks. And I mean fucking everything. LeBron needs to have a triple-double. Dwayne Wade needs to play like he did in game 5 where he went off. Chris Bosh needs to play like Chris Bosh. But the Chris Bosh that was getting blocks, that Chris Bosh. And then all their shooters, and then we get Hito Turkoglu. I don't get to sell him now because he's currently injured. He will be a part of the Black Friday fire sale when injured players get taken off luck. And I'll be doing a huge pack opening for that. probably almost 200k, but that is in the future. Anyway, Chris Bosh, he needs to, get blocks, defend the rim, and then all their shooters cannot miss. If all of that happens, LeBron will be holding his trophy tonight, and he will be shaking his stepfather's hand, meaning David Stern, for the last time, because I think after this season, David Stern steps down as commissioner for the NBA, and what the hell? Another Maurice Cheeks. That's, I think, like the third one that I've gotten in all of my pack openings I've uploaded so far. He is just, look, I was so angry. I was just, as I was saying, David Stern being LeBron's stepfather. So, oh yeah, and by the way, this video was edited for time restraints. I did cut off when I finished that 30k and I sold Andre Kirilenko and then started up with his money. So you know what I mean. But anyway, David Stern, honestly, I am so happy that he is stepping down as commissioner, because I honestly don't like the way David Stern deals with the NBA. He is, I don't know what happened to him from the 90s to now, because 90s basketball was just so much more entertaining. I mean, it just was. It just was. Like, there was nothing greater than seeing someone able to dunk on somebody else, put their nuts legitimately in their face, point at them, laugh, run away, and don't get a technical or a fine. And they could cuss, and it wouldn't be... Oh! Speaking of getting dunked on, Patrick motherfucking Chewing. If you don't know what I mean, then you should go look up when Jordan dunked on Patrick Ewing. Was it Jordan or Pippen? One of them dunked on Patrick Ewing. Sick poster. But I pick up Patrick motherfucking Chewing. He is an awesome pickup because I'm a Knicks fan and I'm Jamaican. So combine those two and Patrick Ewing could arguably be one of my favorite players, but he is not. Anyway, what was I getting at? LeBron and David Stern. David Stern, I don't know, yo. He's softened up a lot over the years. And I just don't like the way he runs. Oh my, what the fuck, 2K? I didn't... Oh, God. I'll just act like that didn't just happen. David Stern. Probably from talking about David Stern. That's why that just happened. He probably heard me. Oh, my God. But that guy... I just preferred 90s basketball. I preferred how the NBA was handled in the 90s. Because it was so much more physical. And it was just more entertaining. Nowadays, if you say it, the slightest... If just the slightest thing will get you a fine. The slightest thing could get you a suspension. Especially the way he recently taught the refs how to officiate. When even if you just touch someone on their pinky fingers, it's a foul. And I just don't like today's brand of basketball. So, I don't expect the next commissioner to be more lenient. But I just don't like David Stern. That was the point that I was trying to make. Especially with how he babies LeBron. Everybody says it, and a lot of people try to just say, David Stern doesn't care about LeBron. David Stern is David Stern. No, David Stern loves LeBron James because LeBron James is the face of the NBA franchise. David Stern... Alright, I'm almost going on a rant, but the whole thing that I was trying to get at is like, when LeBron won his first ring, it was like, you know the AT&T little kid commercial that they show? Like during all of the timeouts, when LeBron won his first ring, basically it was like the little kids saw it and went to David Stern and said, "We want more, we want more, we need more, he needs more rings, we want more." And that's how I saw it in my head, and that's very funny. Fuck you if you didn't laugh, because that was funny. But yeah, coming up to the end of the video, I opened as many packs as I possibly could. I cut off a part where I sold some players and opened some more. But it was just Andre Blatch and shit like that. So I only opened like 3 packs, didn't get anybody. So to top this day off, I got 2 Maurice Cheeks. 1 Tom Sanders and Patrick Ewing. I don't know if I should be upset because I got 3 duplicates and 4 legends overall. or if I should be happy that I at least got one legend and I have luck to get four legends in 30k. I don't know, but I was pissed. But at least I got Patrick Ewing. You see me here, this is, I think this is what I was talking about. Oh, I guess I did show this, I didn't cut it. But yeah, I went back, bought a couple more packs, didn't get anybody. God, hold on. Yeah, didn't get anybody. Monty Williams, you're not somebody, even if you were on the Knicks. But I have one more, I think, one more video coming up in the quest for West. And then after that, I think I'll be uploading that tomorrow. And then I think on Saturday or Sunday, I'll be uploading the cut-up version of the fire sale day where I sell all my injured players and just go on a pack opening spree. Hopefully that day I can get Mr. Jerry West, or even maybe a Sean Kemp or a Gary Payton. I'd love Gary Payton. So yeah, I'll hope for the best. And right now I'll just go check out Mr. Patrick Ewing's stats, because he, that guy, yo, if it wasn't for him being 32 with 62-year-old knees, he could have been one of the greats. Well, he is one of the greats, but could have been one of the greater greats. Great low post offense, a great mid-range jump shot, and he can block and protect the paint. No athleticism whatsoever, but that's fine. A 98 post fadeaway, that's great. So a great pickup in Patrick Ewing. I hope you guys like it. Like, comment, and subscribe.